Hey, what's up, everybody? Dave Schwartz here. It is 17-3 at the half. 17-9. The Vikings are leading at the half right now in a, I'll say a little predictable, but maybe not. I kind of felt like this was going to be a bit of a trap game for the Tennessee Titans, and it seems that they have. The Titans have not looked very good coming in here. Ryan Tannehill, not good. Derrick Henry's barely gotten a lot off. The defense has been surprisingly good for the Vikings today. Harrison Smith with an interception. They've gotten good pressure up front. The fill-ins, you know, on the defensive back, the fill-in in the defensive secondary, have played pretty well. So, by and large, a pretty good defensive effort. On the offensive side of the ball, Justin Jefferson, his absolute breakout game. He's got 104 yards so far in the first half alone. No touchdowns yet. Adam Thielen has a touchdown. Dalvin Cook has a touchdown. And we just had a field goal here with about a minute to go. So should have been in Jefferson week one. You know, that is an interesting thought because they did start BC Johnson the first 2 weeks, and it was not really much of a threat. Justin Jefferson gives the offense just enough to get the defense to be honest with Adam Thielen. And then he has kind of been a little more wide open. Obviously, he caught that touchdown. Yes, they found their game working as a team. Cousins still needs to go, a lot of people say. Cousins' quarterback rating actually is like in the 140s, I think, last time I checked. So pretty good first half overall for the Vikings, the offense and the defense. Still, I'll say, suspect at times on some of the play calls. I've been interested a couple times where they tried to, you know, a wide receiver end around. You don't pay your running back, but you pay him to have that. But overall, pretty good first half for the Vikings. The question is now, what kind of adjustments are going to be made? It's a start, Ken says. Finish the game and do it again next week. Glad Jefferson's getting the ball, long overdue. I'll say this about Jefferson. It's always really good when you can have that breakout game. But the problem is now next week he'll probably garner a little more attention. So can you do it 2 weeks in a row? Can you make that adjustment 2 weeks in a row? And then... Will Adam Thielen have the big game, which worked so well with Thielen and Diggs when they were here at their time together? 1 week, one would have had a good game. The next week, it was the next guy. And so, you know, can Justin Jefferson be that guy? Certainly in the first half so far, we have seen him play very, very well. He's made some really good catches. He's had some run some great routes, great yak yards as well. So he has been that guy, and it's just enough to kind of leave, take the pressure a little bit off Adam Thielen. He's open, and Cousins is finding him, which is really, first and foremost, that's what they needed. The offensive line has been surprisingly better today, I think, especially on that Dalvin Cook touchdown. It goes right through the line, a great hole for him to run through. So Doug says, who cares? Cousins still needs to go. Never been a fan of him in the NFL in his career. Bring in the rookie, find a better QB. They don't have real, I mean, unless you're talking about Nate Stanley, who I don't really think is a viable option at this point. I'll say it again. The one thing people have to remember about the NFL is it's what have you done for me lately. If Nate Stanley was better than Kirk Cousins, Nate Stanley would be playing right now. Because if you lose, your job gets threatened. If you win, you get to stay. There isn't really favoritism because you can't afford it in the NFL. If they truly thought Nate Stanley was the quarterback of the future or Sean Mannion was the quarterback of the future, then he'd be playing right now. But he's not. So there's a reason Kirk Cousins, as bad as he's been at times, today he looks better, but as bad as he's been at times, he is still their best option. Add Captain Munderland. Hey, I'm a big Captain Munderland fan. Hope it's not a blip. Justin Jefferson might have saved the Vikings season. Tannehill has had a lot of time done, and he still looked terrible. I mean, let's be honest. He still looked bad. I have not, that last series was okay, but I have not seen a lot out of Ryan Tannehill today that I've been super impressed with. Something to cheer for, a lot of people excited. So again, Vikings right now leading at the half 17-9. We're just about getting ready to start the second half in a couple minutes. Can they do it? Can they hold on? The NFL is a game of adjustments. Mike Zimmer's always been great at making adjustments. Probably doesn't have to make too much today because they're playing well. The Titans will make adjustments. You know, will that hamper Justin Jefferson? Will they kind of rein in Dalvin Cook? What's Derrick Henry going to do in the second half? Because he's been almost non-factor in the first half except for a couple runs. So Vikings winning right now 17-9. Second half coming up. We will see you again tonight on the Vikings Extra. as well as on Carol Levin News at 5 here from Viking from U.S. Bank Stadium. Tim says, I wish they'd use Rudy and Erd more. You know, that is an interesting point, Tim. They haven't used them much at all. Excuse me. They really haven't used them much at all and haven't needed to because they've had the good matchups on the outside. So we'll see you back here tonight live at 5 o'clock. And again, tonight following the Sunday night football game, we will see you tonight on Carol Levin News.